Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Kartikeya Bardar, and it's a proud privilege for me to welcome you all to Exchange for Media and Samachar for Media presents Media Educators of India Media and Media Education Summit. Before going any further, I would like to take this moment to thank all our partners for making our event today possible. The event is in association with BW Businessworld, co-partnered by ABP News, gifting partner Bio Ayurveda, live webcast partner 24 Frames Digital, trade media partners Impact, Pitch, Future Play, Realty Plus, the music community partner Loudest, the CSR partner Please and Strides Foundation. Before going any further, I would request and urge all our attending delegates to please maintain silence while a panel is on and to kindly put your phones on silent mode. Ladies and gentlemen, as the digital era cascades forward, the world is witnessing changes on an unprecedented scale. Industrial Revolution 4.0, is one that may change how people work, socialize, and educate. With the changing distribution networks, traditional media as an industry is facing grave challenges, while new developments are widening the horizons of media consumption. This also adds new dimensions to media education and the kind of training that would best equip a new age journalist. The search for new professional and educational paradigms that help in the interpretation and management of this double change is the goal of today's conference. The first of its kind conference on the future of media and media education serves as a platform to bring media educators, media owners, editors, journalists, and HR heads on one dais for discussing the current status and future prospects, vision, and challenges in media and media education in India. Without further ado, I would like to kickstart today's proceedings by calling upon Dr. Annurag Batra, Chairman and Editor at BW Businessworld and E4M Group, to kindly come on stage and deliver the inaugural speech. Dr. Batra.
Good morning. It's my honor and privilege to be here. This is the first Media Educators of India conference, and it has happened because Dr. Surbhi Raya and me met about 40 days back, maybe 42, but less than 1.5 months back, and it's really a collaboration between us and Dr. Daya. So please give Dr. Daya a big round of applause. Because she sent me a WhatsApp. She sent me a WhatsApp, and you know, I'm a madman. Don't take that too seriously. But I can only tell you that this is the first year. I promise you, like kids, conferences grow up. We do 170 conferences, and we started some with 10 people. I was just telling my team, I mean, I was giving them a revenue example, but I guess because revenue is black and white, a conference that does about 2 crores for us in a year, when we started in the first year, was a 6 lakh conference. We couldn't even cover the cost, which was about 15 lakhs. So today it makes sense. That's our digital media awards and conference. It does about 2 crores of billing, right? So conferences are like kids. They grow up. They evolve. They become nurturing. So it is the first year. We must celebrate. And really, the reason we did this is, one, I'm a failed education entrepreneur. I started a media school 5 years. Started it 11 years back. I didn't start. A friend of mine started. I invested. And then my friend Atul Maheshwari of Amar Ujala also became a large shareholder. And then Atulji went to heaven, so we shut down the institute. Rubika Liaquat, who now anchors on ABP News, is from my media school. And maybe next year we will relaunch the school. It is a possibility. So really, I understand the media education domain. And I was talking to my partner with whom we started. And because Atulji died, so we shut it down. No other reason. थोड़ा दिल खट्टा हो गया वो अकस्मात उनके निधन से यू नो ही वाज सो आई मेट हिम ऑन 8th नवंबर दैट ईयर एंड देन ही पास्ड अवे ऑन 2nd जैन सो यू नो ही हैपेंड टू कम टू माय बिल्डिंग आई वाज एंड ही सडनली वेंट अवे सो वी शट डाउन द इंस्टीट्यूट सो आई अंडरस्टैंड मीडिया एजुकेशन लिटिल बिट आई एम आल्सो अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ मीडिया सो आई एम people like Mr. Badal are here. I must say that I was born to academic parents. My mother was a school teacher in a government school in Sohna. So I would go with my mom. I was 6 years old in a Haryana Roadways bus from Old Gurgaon. I grew up in Old Gurgaon. Not that I've grown up, sir. I've just lost hair. That doesn't mean one has grown up. And then she became a principal. I was 8 years old or 9 years old. My father studied at BITS Pilani, but he chose to be a professor. For the longest period, he was a professor at the Common College Gurgaon. Then he became a head of department, and he became a vice principal. And in the last year of his principalship, I think that's the only 1 year he's not been in that college, he became the principal of the Vash College in Bhiwani. And luckily, I passed out of Bhiwani. I studied at a textile college. I went to TIT Bhiwani, whose 75th anniversary is being celebrated on Saturday. I'm not being able to go, but... So I know a little bit about academics, and I must tell you that about... Day before yesterday, I met someone. We had a B-School conference, and Dr. Pritam Singh, I studied at MDI. I got into MDI when the quality control was bad. I'm from the first batch of that business school. After that, they've kind of tightened. So somebody met me and he said, oh, you're MDI director. I said, by the way, 8 years back, I told my wife that I'd love to be the director of MDI. So my wife said, are you really mad? You know, I was 38 years old then. And I said, what's wrong with it? He says, once they retire, they become professors. I said, that's not true, Niti. So really, I have a love for academicians and academics. Fortunately or unfortunately, my job is a lot more administrative and it's a lot about content and not about teaching. Just to contextualize the media educators of India, the fact is today we have the cream of the media education in this room, and some senior people's flights are delayed, but they'll be here. Why this conference? I think we at exchange4media, we started exchange4media almost 18 years back. Exchange4media for the last 16 and a half years, for every single day there has been a newsletter. Every single day. And we can safely say that in this business, and it is the business of media, advertising, marketing, communication, we dominate this space like almost having 500 seats in Lok Sabha, that kind of domination. And we do it year on year on, because we have the best edit team. I mean, no other reason. We have the best editorial. And everybody in our domain first talks to us for advice, then gives us... We are the first one to break 99% of the stories. I won't say 100%, but sometimes we know the stories, we can't, because they've been told to us as a friend. So that's the only reason we don't do the rest one. For example, Raj Naik's story, I knew it for a long time, and I'm sure if you now look back at the photos on Friday, you knew that because he and me were having a good time. We couldn't have broken it. Because he's told me as a friend, I keep telling my team stories, to aati jaati hai, dost nahi aate jaate. So, really, because we built, and we are very middle of the road. Badal Sahab is there, we have no political affiliations, we are very middle of the road. We do not favor anyone. And we are under fire from everyone, and we run stories. So exchange4media, and then Samachar4media in 2010, 8 years back, we started our Hindi site. Because Hindi patrikarita bahut bada ek subdomain hai. Sabse, aur jo hamari sabse jyada desh ke log hai, wo Hindi mein content ka sevan karte hai. If we cannot make a difference to the Hindi journalism, so we cannot make a difference to journalism. So we started it for the first 3 years. Neeraj Singh was the editor. For the last 5 years, Abhishek is the editor. And he's really taken Samachar4media to another level. I love his headlines. I mean, I keep showing everyone how he does headlines. So between exchange4media.com and Samachar4media, exchange4media is more marketing, advertising, and then media. Because brand managers and media, people who buy media read us. So about 600 media brands advert. But because my personal interest in media, media stories take precedence. Because we cannot be about media and not write about media content. Because really that's what drives, especially in news media. In Samachar4media, it is more about journalism. Advertising is secondary. So that's the way. Then we have a weekly called Impact. This year is the 15th year of the weekly. Our 14th year of the Impact Person of the Year. It's on the 7th December. And I can tell you it is the biggest award in this business. Only one person we select through a poll with AC Nielsen, 2,500 senior leaders in our industry we poll. So we said we are in every segment. I don't want to tell you, we do 32 conferences and all of them are impactful. Forget the money. Money is not the most important thing. It's what's the content, what is the impact on you make on your industry? Are you able to bring new ideas? If you do that, money also comes. And money is important because you need to sustain them. So it's not that money is not important, but it's not the most important thing. So we said we don't have a, you know, when she said, oh, I'm doing a directory, I'm compiling, I said, why don't we create a conference on media education? Because really, if the media business is changing, then the media education domain needs to keep pace. And I'm sure it's keeping pace. But let's bring all the media educators together and create a platform for them. Because really, and I said, the only thing they must do is the most important thing is to create spine in journalists. The course called, you know, spine. So because if you don't have spine, everything else you learn possibly won't be relevant. So that's how this conference came about. And I'm saying this is the first year. We've done it at 35 days. I have not been around, except yesterday I was running very high fever. I'm running high fever now. But I went to office at 3 p.m. to review the conference for an hour because really it's an important, we've invited all of you. So if in the first year there are minor logistics issues, anything, please forgive us. It is the first year, but I promise you, second year it'll be 5 times bigger and it will be a calendar event. Then we were sitting and, you know, what I like about Dr. Dahiya is she's a doer, she's a pusher. Without pushing, nothing happens. You know, sometimes I get irritated also. I tell her I can't answer that many WhatsApp. Please don't send me. And you know, but if she didn't push, it won't happen. It won't happen, I promise you, right? And she suggested some things, and then she said, why don't we do awards? I mean, she said, I said, let's do it. Then my association with IMC started with a gentleman called Dr. K.M. Srivastav. He is in heaven now. I first met him at a Madhya Pradesh Foundation dinner here some 10, 11 years back, Dr. Balla's event. And then he said, gaadi hai tumhare paas? I mean, if you know how he used to speak. So, mere chhudwa do. So I said, okay, sir. And then he became a very close friend of mine. He would stay at my home and he was bachelor. So he, you know, he wouldn't take care of himself. So one day I saw his feet were swollen. And I told him, please come to my home. And then one of my senior colleagues took him to the hospital. And we became very, very, very close. I mean, he would call me and saying, aaj main kuch nahi kar raha hu, main aa jaun. Right? I mean, he wrote 11 books on media. He was a kind man. And I'm not saying it because it's fashionable to, he was, I would say these things about him when he was there. So he said, why don't we do a Dr. K.M. Srivastava? I said, okay. And then we thought of some other categories. And I said to her, we should give one in each. But when we, and then she said, okay, let's decide. I said, let's do it through a process. Let's invite nominations. Because it shouldn't, the only difference between one award and another award is how honestly it's done. She can now say that we don't run agendas. Rest, all of us are human beings. We have our biases. You know, we may think somebody is better than, though. All those can be there. So we assembled a jury and I called my guru, because he was my teacher, Dr. Pritam Singh. When I was studying in MDI in 94, he was the director of the institute. He's a Padma Shri. He was on the Prime Minister's Institution of Eminence jury, and he's an educationist par excellence, and he doesn't come from media. So in some sense, he is not biased by who you know. So he said, we'll get him to chair. We invited Shri Alok Mehta ji. I called people who would come in, like, who wouldn't ask me too many questions and who have locus tendi, both. So we should have invited you, Badal ji, but it didn't come to my mind. And so I said practitioner, I called Milind, but Milind was not there that day. So I called the CEO of ABP News, the business side. And I called Sajal Mukherjee. So I called people, I can just pick up the phone. And we did the jury meet and we had a healthy discussion. And during the discussion, we said, why one? I mean, I was the first one to say not more than one. But it was so close, it was so difficult. Because on a CV, unless until you know the person, I can tell you that whatever, I mean, Dr. Dahiya is very dynamic. I mean, that there is no question about, right? And I said, you shouldn't get an award because you are co-creating it with us. Because it's like, you know, it wouldn't be nice. Ideally, I would not even, I told her 2-3 times, you shouldn't be involved in it because you know everyone, so you will have some biases. So the good thing is you have knowledge, but you also have biases. So we tried to make the process as honest. We sat down in a room, discussed every name. We looked at profiles. and we decided the winners. There are 22 winners. We started with 7, we'll do 7. But, you know, in some categories we've done 3 because there was very little difference to choose. It was very difficult, you know. Unless until I mean, I can say in media I know everyone. I know about 100,000 people in the media industry, with all humility. So that's how the awards were decided, which will be given away in the evening. I really wanted Harivansh ji to come because he was a journalist and he's now the vice chair. And I called him, it's just that I got a little late. He's in Ranchi today, he had some engagement. But we'll do the awards in the evening, they're in the Fountain Lawn. So this is the, and the last, which is the starting point, is the directory. It started as a 200-page directory. I was told last evening it is a 1,000-page directory. 1,000-page directory, right? So we'll bring it out, we'll launch it today. And again, you know, educators, you know, in our, Dr. Bahal and me were talking, and Dr. Bahal said that the Supreme Court has now said that the educators are nation builders. Let me tell you, a newspaper in UK does an annual survey, and it asks for the most respected professions and the least respected. Guess which is the most respected? Doctors. Which is the second most respected? Teachers. Right? And you know, I have to say that we should, and the most least respected, guess which is the least respected? Politics. Second is police. I think media is at 5. Right? We need to do better. I mean, not go up, go down. Right? So, I'm just trying to tell you that educators are people we don't celebrate. We have to pay more to our educators. You know, my friend Rishi Singh is there, Colonel Largan walks in. Colonel Largan, welcome. So I know the private side of media schools, you know, I know the ASCOs, the APJ. I didn't know, so today I'll get to know all of you. And I like Colonel Largan because he calls me for placement of students. I like people who call for help. I do half day, I do this. I call people for jobs, other people's jobs, things, you know. If you know me, I will call for favors all the time, but not for myself. Not for myself, okay? So I like people, you know, he's not necessarily all the students you give us are good, but 2 of them have been very good, Colonel Lagan. Siddharth is outstanding. So this is the, so the directory will come out. Today we'll launch the directory. Unfortunately, today the copies won't be up for sale, but in a week they'll be up for sale. So this is the genesis of the conference. It happened on a WhatsApp, and I went and met her while coming from the airport, and you know, so this is the genesis of the conference. What would we like to do better next year? One, we'd like to do it with a 6-month planning. Second, a lot of things have been last minute, briefing you on the agenda, what is your timing of the session. And you know, because I have my parents are academicians. I know academics, how I think I know how academicians think. So, you know, they're more organized, they're more regimented. I'm an entrepreneur. My ability to deal with uncertainty is of a different level, you know. So next year there'll be more predictability. You'll be made more comfortable. It'll also be bigger, better. But what we've been able to do is, we told Dr. Dahiya that you bring the professors, and we know some. So I requested Colonel Largan, I requested Mr. Bahal. We'll bring the whole industry. Rajesh Badalji is there. My young friend Tarun Nangia, who does 2 shows on NewsX, 1 show on legal called Legally Speaking, which is in the top 50 shows by Bark, and the other is on policy. So Tarun is here. So next year, we have not involved the private schools. So there is no Asian College of Journalism. MICA wants to be a B school, but it is a communication school. I mean, if I can keep saying I'm Shahrukh Khan, I'm not Shahrukh Khan. Right? So point I'm trying to make is, we would include those schools. This year, the focus has been more universities, and I'm glad, because the number of students that come out of universities, I mean, all the universities there I'm seeing, I mean, these are really top-notch universities, and in journalism, they produce professionals. Now, I know the IMC students are there, and, you know, I wanted it to be a ticketed conference. I wanted award entries to be, because that's how, anything that is free is not taken seriously. So it is not about money making. You know, 500 bucks or 1,000 or 3,000 bucks is, and 50 entries is like 1.5 lakhs. It's not going to make. But next year we'll do all that. But this year we wanted to. Seriousness. And at the end of the day, we also have to make it sustainable. Because if it's not sustainable in media industry, if you're not financially profitable, you will not have a spine. You will not. So being financially sustainable in everything is equally important as putting great content, as involving the community. So I just wanted to give you a context. My friend Shiv Kumar, Radhika, is my presentation there? You guys haven't taken it from Tanvi? Right, like lots of things. But I'll give you a context. We had our B-School conference. And the only thing that matters in a B-School is, to me, is placements. Placements happen when everything else is right. When the infrastructure is right, the professors are top-notch, they do research, they do consulting, they're encouraged to go out and talk to industry. You attract the right students because of a certain... Because I know a little bit about B-School, a lot more about B-School, and I know a lot about media. Media school, I ran one for 5 years, so I know a little bit, not as much as you, and I don't know it as much as you, but I have some understanding. So I prepared a presentation which is not, but I just wanted to say that I'd say five things to educators there. One, people in the industry can learn from them, because the basis of education and the principles will never change. The technology will change, the tools will change, the terminology may change, but the basics don't. Second, I would say to the educators, is that we all need to, I need to evolve. I used to do exchange4media, and I acquired Businessworld, we turned it around. It was a very tough process. I mean, very tough to change an organization that exists for 33 years and change the culture. In the business school, I used to think, what is culture? Right? I was born in Haryana, that's where we don't think about it. We do it. Right? So culture change. So I just want to say that I evolved from running E4M to running BW. I may do bigger things in the next 3-4 months when BW is at the level of E4M. E4M is super profitable, but most importantly, very impactful. Right? So you have to reinvent yourselves as teachers. And the reason you're here, you'll meet some people from the industry. Third, everything is digital. We are not in the print business, we are not in the digital business, we are not in the TV business. We're in the business of brand and content. So it doesn't matter, it's about content. And video is becoming bigger and bigger and bigger. I love reading because I am of a certain age. But if you talk to a 25-year-old, they're 80, they read also. To say they don't read, I have two kids, I can tell you they love reading. Especially my daughter who's older. But they consume a lot of video. So the journalism is moving towards video. Let's be very clear on that. Video is easy to watch with excess prices coming down. Fourth, since the time I entered this profession 18 years back, I didn't go to a media school. I did what most Indians do before they do anything. I went to an engineering school, then went to business school. Is that for the first time, Hollywood, which is film content, advertising, which is Madison Avenue, and Silicon Valley, which is technology, are coming together. Pehli baar aisa ho raha hai jahan actually ho raha hai. It is very difficult, technology is becoming so important. So teaching technological tools in media schools will be very, very important. And last but not the least, the threat of fake news. Social media is not content. It is not journalism. It is a point of view at best. Social media is a distribution mechanism. And I give this example that a friend of mine, 45-year-old journalist, and I don't want to give his name, he's single, posted on Facebook, I want to commit suicide. And 65 of his friends said, we like this. So social media is not serious. That's the point I'm trying to tell you. It's a distribution mechanism. It's not content, it's not journalism. But we must do courses on fake news, how to counter fake news. Because we in the media are at the receiving end of it. We are not creating it. Parties are creating it. Governments are creating it. Institutions that have an agenda are creating it. Media is not creating it. And this whole thing, whether it's Donald Trump or other leaders, I got my US visa last week, so I can joke about Donald Trump. To portray media as like anti-country, anti-world, anti-government. I mean, if media is anti-government, then they're doing their job well. We in India are not doing our job well. The job of the media is to report on the government of the day, because they are taking decisions. So that's why I jokingly said when we started, we have to have a course on spine building of journalists. And, keep having that course every 6 months. So this is what I would like to say. We'd love to learn from you. What will be discussed today during the day is being played on our platforms, which are read by everybody in the media industry. I don't want to drop names, but they call people like Abhishek and say, headline aisi nahi hai, naam you can take the top 50 names in Indian journalism in a week, at least 40 of them call. And it, because we have their community, we are part of them, they are part of us. And anybody who talks to, you know, it's very fashionable to criticize journalists. You know, we in media are doing this job in a very tough environment. Media owners have to have a spine. The business people have to have a spine. A free media is very important for the growth. You know, we are doing this job in very tough environment. So it is very fashionable to say ki media wale aise hai, media wale waise hai. But wo kahin Mars Venus se nahi aaye, wo yahi aap mein aur mujh mein se hi nikle. A friend of mine who did a scam, and he always complains to me about media people, once said to me that media wale aise hai, waise hai. So one day mereko NK Singh ji ne blood donation camp ke liye press club mein bola, main press club jata nahi hu. But main gaya and I called this friend of mine. I want to give you an industrialist. And I told him, let's say Mehra Saab, ka naam kuch aur hai, but let's say Mehra Saab, ki yahan pe sab sampadak hai, unka khoon lal hai, hamare jaisa hi hai. Mehra Saab to Mehra Saab hai, unhone bola, haan, hamara hi to peete hai, lal hi hoga. So point to paint journalists and media professionals that, you know, some evil people who come from somewhere, some other distant planet is wrong. Yes, I agree, we in the media can do a better job on reporting today. We are, and the era is of domain expertise. You have to create domain expert journalists. I was doing an interview, I asked her yesterday, she wants to write on politics. I asked her, who's the vice president of India? She didn't know. Abhishek, you were sitting in the interview. She didn't know who is the vice president of India. I don't know, how can I add a person like that? Luckily, she knew the name of the president. So that was the saving grace. And so I just want to say that technology is changing the media business. And hence the business of media education. Let's say domain. And I don't want to call it a business because it is a very noble profession. But the domain of media education will need to keep pace. The professors will have to reinvent themselves. And today is a bridge between the industry and media educators. And we've called this the media educators of India. So this is to the great work you do. So I would like to say that we are fortunate that you are here. I'll get to meet some of you today. I'm here whole day, which is rare at a conference. I'll go out for 1 hour though. And there are some people who are not in the agenda who will show up from the industry. And Abhishek will tell you the names. But, you know, we've called our friends, and right now is the election season. So Rajdeep is here, and, you know, somebody is traveling there. But everybody is committed that next year they will come to this conference. So with this long, long speech, I would like to go back and say thank you for being here, and I look forward to interacting with you. Thank you.